Okay, children, starting with a new topic today. Yesterday we discussed the SSS congruency criterion, that is the side-side-side congruency criterion. Today we are going to study another congruency, okay, when in any two triangles they will be said to be congruent if any two sides are equal, and the angle between those two sides are equal. Matlab, this side is equal to this side, this side is equal to this side, this angle is equal to this angle. Now, this angle is made by these two sides, right? So, the angle, the corresponding sides are equal, and the angle formed by those corresponding sides, you can say the angle in between those corresponding sides are equal. Okay, so this type of congruency is said to be side angle side. Okay, once again, side angle side congruency, that means SAS congruency. Now this was for one side, that is one type I showed you. Now I have made two more examples for that. Like for example, here this angle was in between. Now if suppose these two corresponding sides are equal, then this angle in between the corresponding side should be equal, then also it is SAS congruency. Similarly, if these two corresponding sides are equal, then this angle is equal, okay, and then we call the SAS congruency. So depending on this congruency, SAS congruency, there is a try these in page number 143. We are going to do that now. Page 143. Try this. So the first question. Question number 1. Which angle is included between the sides DE and EF of triangle DEF? So you can make there only. You have to do it in book. This exercise has to be done in book. Means this, try this. So we make D, E, F. Okay. Now, which angle is in between DE and EF? DE and EF. Which angle is there? Angle E. Okay. So, this is your question number 1. Then, question number 2. By applying SAS congruency rule. SAS congruency rule means side, angle, side. You want to there in symbolic form. So let's make the diagram. Question number 3, there are 4 parts. I just take a minute to complete the diagram. We have to find out which. We have to find out which angles are congruent following the SAS congruency, and then we have to write them in symbolic form also. So you can see 2.5, 2.5, 2.8, 2.8, but the angle is not equal. So directly you write no. Then here 35, 35, 2.5, 2.5, 3 and 3. Yes, they are congruent. Okay, so we have to write in symbolic form. So let me write the names ABC and PQR. ABC, ABC, and where is PQR? This is P, this is Q, this is R. Yes, by SAS congruency, na? Side, angle, side. Side, angle, side. So this actually it should be like this. This. So P will come here, R will remain here, and this will remain. This will come. So this way. Okay. So triangle ABC is congruent. C is congruent to RQP. Triangle RQP. You can write here SAS rule. SAS congruency, that is side, angle, side. Then coming back here, here also this is congruent. You can see 3.5, 3.5, 3, 3, 40, 40. Let me write the name DEF. DEF. PQR. So let's say PQR will become like this. Q will come here, R will come here, and P will come here. Okay? For showing the corresponding sides. So it is yes. And which triangles are congruent? Triangle DEF. Triangle DEF is congruent. DEF PRQ. P triangle PRQ. Okay, that is why we make a small corresponding to the triangle, we make a small triangle at the side. Okay, taki koi confusion na ho, we will not get confused. I have seen, you know, this 40 has to be, this 40 is this side, so this 40 should also be this side. So it will make a lot of confusion. So that is why we make a rough like this, putting 40 this side just to show the corresponding angles. Okay, and here also you can write by SAS congruency. Now here, these triangles are congruent, 3.5, 3.5, So Q and P. R should come here and P should come here. Yeah, that is correct. Okay, so PS is equal to PQ. PS is equal to PS. No, PS is not equal to PQ. SR is equal to SR is equal to PQ. Where is PQ? PQ. P should come here now. Where is 30 degree? This is 30 degree. P. This is R. And this is 30 degree. Correct. Now. SR is equal to PQ. PQ. Angle P is equal to angle R. Yes. And PR is equal to PR. PR is equal to PR. Yeah, correct. So this way will be the rough figure. So from here we can show the congruency triangle PSR or PRS is congruent to triangle RPQ. Okay. By SAS congruency. So this completes question number 3. We go to question number 4. In figure 7.25, AB and CD bisect each other at O. That means O is the midpoint of AB and CD. So let's make the figure. This is O. This is C. This is A. This is B. And this is D. So this part is equal to this part. This part will be equal to this. OC is equal to OD and OA is equal to OB because AB and CD are bisecting at O. So state the three pairs of equal parts in two triangles. In two triangles. AOC and BOD. Triangle AOC and triangle BOD. My phone is okay. Is it working? Yeah, it's okay. AOC and BOD. Okay? So very simple. Either you make the rough one. That is AOC and BOD, something like this. Okay, now OA is equal to OB and OC is equal to OD. Correct? And this angle will be equal because they are vertically opposite angles. Yes, the angle AOC is equal to angle BOD. Okay, so we'll write that. So what are the three parts? First part is OA is equal to OB, OC is equal to OD. You can write here O is the midpoint. The reason is because O is the midpoint. Then angle AOC is equal to angle BOD. Angle BOD. Angle AOC is equal to angle BOD. Okay, so that is is right. What we write here, we write here vertically. Opposite. This only we had to do. We had to find out the three parts. So I took three part. Okay. Now question number two of the same question. Which of the following statement is true? Second one. Which of the following statement is true? First one. Triangle AOC is congruent to triangle DOB and B part. Triangle AOC is congruent to triangle BOD. So, beta, if you go to the first one, you have proved here, na? So, AOC is congruent to BOD from here. So, here you can write hence. Triangle AOC is congruent to triangle BOD by SA's congruency. Yes, by SA's congruency. So you see, which option is correct? First one we have already proved, hai na? So from the first question, we can say that option B is correct. AOC is congruent to BOD. Correct? So this completes the try these. Rest we are going to continue tomorrow. Please do it in book. Just try these.